Hi guys, this is Amar and welcome to Amar Tech Stuff. Guys, in this video we'll try to solve a ticket. This ticket says that a router R1 and R2 both are showing as active in HSRP. R1 should be active and R2 should be standby. So guys, in this diagram you can see there are two routers which are in the LAN connected via this switch, and R1 is the primary router and R2 is the secondary router, and they both are participating in HSRP. But here the case is that R1 is inactive, which is okay, but R2 is also inactive, which is not what we need. R2 should be in standby. Let's check first of all in R1. To check HSRP status, the command is show standby brief. And guys, here you can see that let me check what this interface is. Fast Ethernet 0. So is this Fast Ethernet 0? Yeah, this is Fast Ethernet 0, and for this also it is Fast Ethernet 0. So these are my LAN ports. Okay, and this is my LAN port, Fast Ethernet 0, which is up. Guys, here you can see that HSRP is in the active state and it is local, but standby, you can see guys, here's a problem that it is showing unknown. Virtual IP is 192.168.1.1. Let me see what is the IP address assigned to this Fast Ethernet interface. Okay, so it is assigned as 192.168.1.2 to this Fast Ethernet 0. Let me check on R2 as well. Show interface description. Here is the LAN interface, Fast Ethernet 0. And let me check the IP address on that same. It is 192.168.1.3. Let us check HSRP status. Show standby brief. Okay, so here you can see the interface, HSRP interface is Fast Ethernet 0 and the state is active. And the standby is again unknown. Virtual IP is correct, 192.168.1.1. Okay, so let us see whether both the interfaces are up. Yeah, this interface is up, as well as this interface is also up. Let me ping R1's interface. We'll check the ping whether we are able to reach it on, because it is showing us unknown. And it should not be unknown. So let us check first of all whether we are able to ping. Well, I think we should ping it from R1, the LAN interface of R2, 192.168.1.3. Yes, we are able to ping. So guys, this may be one reason that, you know, the LAN interface may be down. So always, whenever you see such a case where both of them are active, or one of them is not participating in HSRP, guys, you can always check whether that interface is up or not. Here the LAN interface, we call that interface as HSRP interface, because that is the interface which is actually participating in HSRP. So here we are able to ping from R1 the HSRP interface of R2. Let's see the other way. It is 1.2. So again, we are able to ping the fast ether 0, that is HSRP interface, from both the routers. Okay. Let us check the configuration of Fast Ethernet 0. Okay, so guys, this is the configuration of Fast Ethernet 0, that is the HSRP interface of R1, and this is the configuration of HSRP interface of R2. So let's compare it. Okay, it is Fast Ethernet 0. So guys, always do use this kind of stuff too, even if you are receiving. I think we are also receiving some duplicate error address messages here on the screen, that is duplicate address is there. okay, because both of them are claiming that even R1 and R2, both of them are claiming as HSRP active. So maybe because of that, this duplicate address. So guys, this is also an error message you would get in your logs if you are facing this issue. So let's see now the configuration what we are comparing. So here I can see it is both of them are fast Ethernet. Description is LAN, that is fine. IP address configured is 192.168.1.2. Okay, here the priority is 115, so it should be active. And here it is not, we have not configured any priority. That means it should not be active. Guys, you can see that here standby 10, this command is missing. So let's configure that thing here under fast Ethernet. Sorry, see here also the messages are repeating. So let's check here also messages are repeating. Let me quickly okay, I think it is, I have mistyped it, so it is taking some time. So guys, whenever you mistype something, it will try to your domain server, refer to the domain server, and it will try to resolve it. Now it is taking a lot of time. Let me take another session. The cancel of the session. This is the R2. So again, it is showing the same thing here. Okay, now it is fine. Let me just increase the font size. Okay, so we were viewing the configuration of interface fast Ethernet 0. Okay, and here was the configuration of fast Ethernet 0 here as well. So guys, we saw that we are missing without this command. Fine, so we'll put this command. Okay, the command goes like standby 10. Actually, this is what we are doing, is we are configuring the virtual IP address 192.168.1.1. Okay, so it is giving an error that address this is in group 20. Okay, so guys, here is the catch, that what we have done a mistake here is while configuring this router, the network admin has put the group number as 20, HSRP group number as 20, and here is the HSRP group number as 10. So this is a problem. So let's correct it. I'll just copy this in a notepad. We'll change it first of all. Okay, that is the reason why both were claiming that they were active, because we misconfigured the HSRP group. So guys, always remember that the HSRP group should be same in for both the routers. It is not locally significant, so we have to keep it as same. Now I'll just copy this. What I'm doing exactly, guys, here is I'm going to remove this configuration, that is standby 20 configuration from the interface, fast Ethernet interface, and put it as standby 10 with this IP address of 192.168.1.1. This is the virtual IP, and preempt is the command which is used to claim the status of active. For example, like if R1 goes down, then R2 should claim that it is active. Then that is the command which is used, that is the preempt command. So always keep this thing in mind. So let us configure it in there. I think so we are in the interface level only, so let's paste it. Now you can see we are seeing some messages here. that it has changed from active to disabled. Okay, HSRP is now disabled for group number 20. Let's check it for group 10. Now you can see it is in the listen mode now. It is in the speak mode now. So it has gone from listen to speak. It was first active, so it went to disabled, it got disabled. Then it got from listen to speak, and from speak to standby now. So this is, we have also seen the HSRP, how the HSRP states are going on changing. So now it is perfect that it is standby, and the active router, it is showing it. This is the IP address of the active router, that is R1. So let's see here also any changes or any effects. A lot of errors were there. Now you can see here the standby router was showing as unknown. Let's see now. Okay, so here the standby router is now showing as 192.168.1.3, which is R2, and again it is local because this is active. So guys, in this way we have solved this ticket. I hope you like this troubleshooting video. Please do subscribe Amar Tech Stuff and keep watching Amar Tech Stuff. Thanks for watching my video.